has begun the rollout of its anti-cancer product called InfuSmart in 6 European countries. To get us more details on this, we're now joined by Helen Decloit, the business head of Western Europe and ANZ at Sun Pharma. Hi Helen, afternoon, and thanks so much for joining in. First, if you could tell us how much this new launch will be in terms of a revenue potential for the company.
That's difficult to estimate because currently there are no cytotoxic products available in a ready-to-use bag. But potentially 60 to 80% of the gemcitabine market could switch to the bag. So that's quite a high potential. And the bag has so many advantages. So it eliminates the risk of dose calculation errors. You don't need to do a compounding step. There's no human intervention. So it's also more safe for the technicians who will need to compound the drug. So many, many advantages to use the InfuSmart.
Well, Helen, what kind of market size are you expecting when you say 60 to around 80% of the market can shift? And by when can that happen?
I think that the market will shift within 2 to 3 years.
Okay.
Europe, is most of it is a tender market, so it will take some time before people eventually can switch. In dollar terms, it's very difficult to estimate. But we will price it competitively and we assume a relatively high market share for this product.
Okay, when is the launch expected and how much will be invested by y'all?
The launches will start in UK and Netherlands because these are the first two countries in Europe where we have final approval. The other countries will follow later this year. And the launch will start actually this month in both countries.
Well, Helen, does the company have a patent on this particular technology? And in that context, what is the competitive environment like?
It is patented.
Okay. All right. Then what is the kind of expansion planned beyond Europe, other developed markets such as US? Is the distribution plan ready to launch?
Right now, the focus is to roll out InfuSmart in Europe. Okay. And to learn from that, and of course we are constantly evaluating to expand, because it's a global development, to expand the product to other markets, including US. But that will be a second stage.
Okay, what are the other kind of products in the R&D pipeline that we can expect for Europe?
The major difficulty is the stability in the bag, so for now we selected 5 products which are stable enough to develop in the bag, and we expect them within the next 3 years to get them launched in Europe and potentially in other regions as well.
All right, Helen, you're planning to expand this in line with other drugs. Take us through the planned investment.
I cannot give you any comments on that.
All right, Helen, thanks so much for stopping by and giving us all those details.